Greetings. This is an important planetary forecast that highlights extraordinary events unfolding in our skies this November. This month's supermoon is a key focal point as it's combined into three important planetary alignments that could be the harbinger for a major earthquake of magnitude 7.5 or higher. This video will focus on specific locations that may be affected. We're now looking at the important astronomical events for the month. We get the important lunar perigee, where the moon will make its closest approach to the Earth for the year, making it a supermoon on November 5, a key time frame. The Moon-Jupiter conjunction takes place on the 10th. Mercury will make a conjunction of Mars on the 13th, and then we get a series of very important planetary alignments. The moon will reach apogee on the 20th. Mercury will reach inferior conjunction, or the Earth-Mercury-Sun planetary alignment, on the 20th. Uranus will be at opposition with Earth and Sun. Then Mercury will be reaching perihelion on the 23rd of the month. Just looking at the important planetary alignments, we get seven of them in November. Mercury will oppose Uranus on the 4th. As mentioned, Mercury will then be a major player as it makes a series of planetary alignments conjoining Mars, opposing Uranus and conjoining the Sun. On the 21st, the Sun will oppose Uranus, so this is a very important time frame just after mid-month. Mercury will conjoin Venus on the 25th, and then Venus will oppose Uranus right towards the end of the month. It must be mentioned that Mercury makes a retrograde in the month of November. It begins on the 9th and completes its retrograde on November 29. The Moon will be at maximum strength in the months of November and December, as we'll be making its closest approach to the Earth for the year. So rounding off the year, we should see some fairly significant geophysical events to follow. There are some that suggest that the month of October is a supermoon, and it's not the case. The supermoons of 2025 are in April, November and December of 2025. Now, this is a template of the supermoons that have coincided with major earthquakes since 2005. We can see some major events, most notably in 2011, a magnitude 9 earthquake that struck Honshu, Japan. The supermoon followed just 9 days after. And we can see a series of very strong earthquakes greater than 7 magnitude showing up on this list. So we do need to consider the potential for a major geophysical event based on the supermoon influence alone. We're now looking at the lunar aspects that will be taking place for the month, and we are looking for multiple connections on a given day, and we get that 5 times in November, so the lunar influence will be extremely important during the month. We get a double conjunction of Moon Saturn, Moon Neptune on the 2nd, and then the 6th, just a day after the supermoon, we get the Moon Uranus conjunction combined into the Moon Mars opposition within a few hours. The Moon-Jupiter conjunction is combined with the Moon-Pluto opposition on the 10th. Then the 20th and 25th stand out as key timeframes to watch as well. We're now using astrocartography and focusing on the planets, their position geodetically mapped to the Earth. And we can see just after the supermoon we get a very powerful Venus having a very strong interaction across Western Turkey. Now the Western Turkey region has been quite active in 2025 with 2 strong earthquakes greater than 6 magnitude. The 6.2 in April and the 6.1 in August. There may be another earthquake to come around Istanbul, and this will be a key area to watch. Now, we note that the chart aspect is showing a very significant Venus having an interaction or yod aspect with both Uranus and Neptune, so it will be highly amplified. And we also get a very strong grand trine aspect involving Jupiter, Saturn, and Lilith. So this is something to watch, and it may represent a kicking off point for a major event in the month of November. There's a lot more going on around this time frame from November 5 through 8. Not only do we get a very powerful Venus, but we also get a very strong Sun moving into a very strong connection with the lunar node. And then we get a very powerful planetary opposition between Mars and Uranus. So this time frame is highly volatile, and it may represent a very strong earthquake for Western Turkey, and potentially a larger quake than magnitude 6.1 and 6.2 that we've already got. Maybe a larger event, and potentially further eastward around Istanbul and around the North Anatolian Fault. We're now going to be focusing on just after mid-month, as it represents the strongest period for a major event, and we're going to be firstly looking at the Saturn-Neptune geodetic position on the Earth. The key areas of focus for a major event will be around the south of Fiji and Kermanic Arc, and stretching northward in towards the Rad Island, Aleutian Island region for a major event. The key area of focus, I feel, will be the Kermanic Arc. Now, I do feel that there is a major earthquake potential in the month of November, and it may be around the Cascadia subduction zone stretching in towards the Vancouver Island region. This is all due to the motion and movement of Uranus, which made its station, and I do feel that we should see a potential release in the month of November. 4 strong earthquakes had struck the west coast of North America region late in 2024. and we may get another strong event. And all of these earthquakes have been attributed and associated with the position of Uranus. Two Uranus stations in 2022 and 2023 coincided with strong earthquakes mapping the exact position of the Queen Charlotte Island 6.5 earthquake and a 6 magnitude earthquake just offshore the coast of Oregon. A planetary alignment and conjunction between Uranus and Jupiter marked the exact epicenter of a 6.4 magnitude earthquake near Vancouver Island, and the offshore Northern California earthquake magnitude 7 attributed to the exact position and longitude of the Uranus-Mars conjunction. Now, I do feel that the Cascadia subduction zone may react with a strong event. This is not only due to the Uranus station of January 2025 marking this location perfectly, but also the Mars interaction with the lunar node. Mars will make a perfect square aspect on the 24th of November, and it highlights a key time frame of strong emphasis for a major event. The Uranus station giving us the location, and the Mars square aspect giving us the time frame and release. If we have a look previously, we have this similar occurrence taking place where Mars squared the lunar node. We see the position of Uranus at station at the time of this square aspect of Mars with the node, and when Mars moves into the opposite side, squaring the lunar nodes again later on the year, we get this major earthquake in the Queen Charlotte Islands, 6.5 magnitude, just 2 days prior to the square aspect of the lunar node. And we get this similar occurrence again in 2025, where we get this symmetry. Mars will square the lunar node on the 24th of November, so we should see another major event when you consider that Mars and Uranus will reach opposition in 2025 in the month of November. During a supermoon month, this could represent a potential for a major earthquake greater than 7.5 magnitude. In summary, I do feel that the month of November represents a very strong risk for a major event. This is based on the supermoon influence, as well as very strong planetary alignments that are coinciding with this influence. I do feel that the key areas of focus definitely will be the Comatic Arc stretching in towards south of Fiji, as well as the Cascadia subduction zone for a major quake in the month of November. For more information, please visit solarwatcher.net and quakewatcher.com. We'll need more information for members and subscribers, as well as website newsletters. Thanks for watching.